Hey everyone, my name is Giz Edwards, G-I-Z-E-D-W-A-R-D-S. A lot of people get my name wrong, and a lot of people say my name as Ed for some reason, because Giz doesn't look like a real name, and to be honest, it's not really. So I've told this story time and time again as to why I'm called Giz, or I've given the most frequently asked questions about my name. On live streams on YouTube, when we used to do Team Lucid Stream, on my own private YouTube channel, Giz Edwards, and also recently on Twitch, I've answered this as well. And if you're not following me on twitch.tv/GizEdwards, link in the description box below, you should. It's cool. We've got a cool community. Have a look. Link in the description box below. But I've never made a dedicated video about my name. Why I'm called Giz? Is it short for anything? What's the story behind it? Is it my real name? Blah, 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 blah. And I decided now is probably a good time. You know, it's only been 13 years since I've made content on YouTube. Might answer this question one day or another. So here are the most frequently asked questions about my name, so we can finally rest this subject once and for all. Frequently asked question number one. What is Giz short for? Nothing. That's what it's short for. It's not short for anything. It's Giz. It's not Gizmo. It's not Gizmaluk. It's not Gizmosis. It's not Gizborn. It's not Gizmondo. It is just Giz. G-I-Z. Not short for anything. Not long for anything either. Frequently asked question number two. Do you know that your name sounds like Giz? Yes. Very aware of that. In fact, I'm so aware of that, that when people try and make jokes about it, I have heard it so many times that it makes me understand that people aren't original at all. I've been called Giz by many people, not just like friends, not just foes, but like doctors, teachers, lecturers at universities, you name it, I've been called it by someone. A prominent story in my mind was somebody who came to my door with like a voter's registration form, and he was looking at all the people who had registered to vote and was asking who they had voted for, or who they were going to vote for rather. And they come to my door and they said, "Are you Mr. Edwards?" And I said, "Yes, I am Mr. Edwards." And he said, "I'm just asking and inquiring, are you going to be voting?" And I said, "No." And he said, "Well, can I try and convince you otherwise to vote for insert party name here?" I said, "You can try," because at the time I was really into politics, but I just never voted. And he said, "Blah, blah, 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 blah." And I said, "Meh, it's not convincing enough for me. I don't think I'm going to vote." And then at the end, he said to me, "See you later, Giz." And I just went, "Well, that was unnecessary," in my mind. So I said to him, "Sorry, who do you say you were voting for again?" And he said, "I'm voting for insert party name here." And I said, "Well, I'm going to vote for the other person because of that." And I closed the door on him. And I didn't vote. I just wanted him to feel like that. But it happens so frequently that it means nothing to me. So when people try and disrespect me by saying Giz instead of Giz, I don't care. Like, I'm 29 years old. Do you think I've never heard that before in my life? It kind of reminds me of the story about the time I met someone called Tom Jones. I went to university recently, met a chap called Tom Jones. When you're at the desk on your first day, you have all the name badges with your names on it. So I was picking my name up, Giz Edwards, and I was pinning it into my thing, into my jumper. And I noticed Tom Jones, and I was like, well, this is a chance for comedy gold. I best linger and wait for Tom Jones to arrive. So Tom Jones came in, picked up his thing, stuck it in his jumper, his t-shirt. And I went up to him and I said, "Well, I was kind of thinking it wasn't going to be the Tom Jones." And he said, "Sorry about that." And I said, "Don't worry. It's because your name, it's not unusual." And he just went, "Yep." And I went, "Oh, he didn't react. Maybe he's heard that probably hundreds of times." I said, "Oh, sorry, mate, you've probably heard that millions of times, haven't you?" He said, "Yeah, I have." I said, "Well, one day I'll think of something new, pussycat." And he went, "Oh, okay." I went, "Oh, damn." I was like, "Sorry, I just had to. You're probably asking yourself, why Delilah?" I come to realize that he had heard that so many times in his life that it meant nothing to him. And it's the same way. It's like meeting somebody called Annie and asking if they're okay, Annie. Or when my girlfriend hears Alice, "Alice? Who the is Alice?" You know, it's like that. If you think you're trying to be original in something, you're not. I've heard it millions of times before. In fact, I make jokes about it myself. I understand if foreign people think it's pronounced jizz because my name in Portuguese, G-I-Z, is pronounced jiz, and it means chalk. It's because I am white. I'll cut that out. Okay, so the next three questions. Is it your real name? Is it the name on your birth certificate? Why did your parents name you Giz? These can all be answered with the same story. So my name is Giz, and I was named Giz when I was a baby, when I was just born, because I made the sound of Gizmo the Gremlin from the film The Gremlins. Classic Christmas film, one of the only Christmas films I will sit down and watch entirely. That's the official story. That's also the true story. But it's not the name on my birth certificate. The name of my birth certificate is Joshua. And the reason the name on my birth certificate is different is because in England, you get one whole month to register your child's name. You get a chance to think your child is nameless at the time, and you think, that's what I'm going to call him. So in that 1 month time, my parents just called me Giz because that was my nickname. Until they decided that Joshua from the U2 album The Joshua Tree was a pretty good name, and they named me Joshua. But they kind of didn't call me Joshua because they've been calling me Giz for a month. That the name Joshua didn't really mean anything to them. They were attached to the name Giz. They went to the doctor and they said, doctor, we want to change his name. Do we have to fill out any forms or anything like that? And the doctor stupidly said, nah, just call him Giz. Should be fine. He was wrong. It was okay during school and during secondary school and a little bit in college. That was all fine. But I realized that I had qualifications and degrees for a name, Giz. I'd gotten my SATs, my GCSEs, I'd gotten various different awards under the name Giz. And when you're growing up in school, you don't realize your name is different. The people that you are talking to grew up with you as being called Giz. It's not an unusual name. I'm thinking about Tom Jones again. I didn't know my name was any different or weird or strange until I got into about college. And then you get all sorts of different people from different places saying, well, that's a really bizarre name. And I thought, yeah, it is actually. It is a bizarre name. I get a national insurance card through the post, which is the equivalent of like social security, I suppose. You get your name and your national insurance number, and it gets posted to you. And that is when you pay healthcare through your national insurance. Every time you work, you have to provide your national insurance so they can take tax out of that to pay for different services like fire, police, and, you know, all that kind of stuff. I wait. I get my national insurance card through the post that says Joshua Edwards. And I'm like, what? Because at this point, I didn't know my name was anything different than Giz. And I'm like, well, what's this? Am I a twin? That was my actual first instinct. Am I a twin? Am I a secret twin? Please tell me I'm a secret twin. Turns out I wasn't. My mum said, yeah, it's your name. So why am I just finding this out now? So I had to legally change my name to Giz so that I would have all of my qualifications under the person who received them. Otherwise, they were invalid. The person didn't exist. I also had to change my name to Giz because my school and college records didn't match my banking information. So if I was to set up a bank account, you have to provide your birth certificate. I provided my birth certificate. It didn't match my college records, so I couldn't claim the EMA, which was a funding thing at the time. You get £30 a week for going to college. So I couldn't claim that because the two things didn't match. So I had to change my name legally, which was not as difficult as it sounds. Getting a passport, I had to provide them with the date, the deed of change of name again, and lots of just little bits and pieces like that. Now that I've got my passport, it makes life a lot easier. So when people ask me, is Giz my real name? I say, yes, it is my real name, but it's not the name of my birth certificate. I show them my passport, I show them my driver's license, and it says Giz. And that's all they need to know. But that's the story of my name. Giz Edwards. It is my real name. It's not short for anything. I was named after Gizmo the Gremlin. Yes, I'm aware it sounds like male fun juice, but also it's not the name on my birth certificate. That's my story. I'm sure many of you have unusual names, so let me hear it. Comment section below. What's your story? Why are you named the way you're named? Actually, why are you named the name that you're given anyway? If you're named James, why are you named James? Come on, James, answer the question, James. So that's my story for now. Don't forget to follow me on Twitch, and until next time, bye!